morning. I'm gonna go check the snares. Set up some more. It's a bit chilly actually. Set up some more maybe. Come back here, eat something. Head out ice fishing. Gonna go to a lake I've never been before. Fishing, I mean, I've been there. I just haven't been fishing there. West Hawk Lake. And we're gonna go for lake trout. And in the evening, we're gonna target burbots. Never caught either of those before, so that'll be fun. I just gotta get out of bed. Fishing and check these when we get back again. It's not very often where you'll get them in the morning after you put them up the night of, so you might get one or two. I didn't get any this time. Snaring's been pretty tough the last 2 years. I used to get them all the time. Now they're not coming out as much. They're not, maybe they're wise. Maybe because I just don't leave them out long enough. But yeah, rabbit lives go in cycles, so it's like every 7 years. I probably got the best. Oh, this is fun. Check this out. Thinking probably deer are pretty hard for them to catch this time of year with the lack of snow, so maybe they're feasting on rabbits more often than not now, or just walking down the trails. Easier going, getting from place to place, so yeah. Well, we'll go back, make some breakfast, and then we'll go do some fishing. Those dots there are a few minnows I threw down the hole. They're sinking to the bottom. One, that green yellow. Let's see if I can zoom in. That green yellow is my left side. Let's see if I can get both. Okay. And then that other one, the other green mark, going up and down, that's my other rod. But those minnows are going down, settling on the bottom, which is exactly what we want. We're going for Lakers, but we're going to chum the water there for the burbots, which should be coming out in the next few hours, if not sooner. So we'll see. We're in about, what, 29 feet of water on the inside bend of a point and the curve of West Hawk Lake. Over there. Nope, over there. It's Peanut Island. There's a bunch of people fishing over there earlier today. Looked a little too crowded for me. Came home to some cookies and some seeds. What a fun treat. Thanks, Trevor and Diane. You guys are the greatest. That's awesome. I'm so excited. Checking snares again. It takes a lot of work to get one. You may or may not get any ever. You may get a bunch. We'll see. Maybe we'll get some this time. Maybe we won't. Nope. Nope. Not looking very good. Nope. Thankful for this guy. It took a lot of work to get him, and he will feed me. He's almost gray a little bit, eh? A little bit of brown still in him. Beautiful snowshoe hare. Beautiful snowshoe hare. Very pleased with that. Two front legs, two back legs, liver, heart, kidneys, front half of the rib cage and upper body for soup stock, back straps, tenderloins. Should be a pretty good meal. I really, really appreciate just getting out here, being able to do some camping, be around nature and just enjoying it. It's so beautiful out. Like, a lot of people don't go out, think I'm crazy because I go winter camping. I understand that thought process. But if you get out a few times, I think your mind will change. It is unreal. Unreal. Yeah, there are cold parts, you know, if the fire dies out, if you're doing hot tenting, because you're not really relying on the fire going out. But if it goes out, yeah, it's cold and you got to start another one. But it's all part of it. It's like sleeping in the tent in July or August when, you know, you put your tent in the wrong spot and you're in the sun and you get woken up at 6 in the morning. And by 7:30, 8 o'clock, it's 50 degrees Celsius in your tent. You know, you just learn to adapt and you make it good. With the right gear, this is the greatest thing ever. When you add other things in, like maybe your chance of getting a rabbit, maybe your chance of getting some fish, it just adds to it. Unfortunately, when I went fishing, some of my friends were on their way over here. So I showed them where my tent was, and they came and they made a fire. Unfortunately, I wasn't here, but they left me some goodies, which was really nice. Weather's perfect. Like, I'm in a sweatshirt right now and I had to take my toque off. It's too hot. But yeah. This is what it's all about. Sounds like I'll be going to school in August or early fall. So I probably won't be able to get out and do elk or moose this year. I might be able to do moose depending on how late this course goes too. But I'm pretty excited about that. Tried something new, decided to go back to the beginning and learn a new skill. So now I'm a sheet metal tin basher, basically, putting together ducting. Fun process, actually, just relearning something new at my age. Seems like a lot of work, but, and it is, but it's rewarding. Keeps the mind working.
That's it. Time to get out of here.
I got a new tent drying system set up. Check that out. And then when I'm done, I just put the tiles back.